I don't think I expected these picks. I know Clovers used to be a ZSS player, although I understood that they were dropping ZSS for Byleth and Aegis for a while. Now we're kind of seeing this matchup, which is, I know, one of the more unconventional ones. Definitely one that ZSS can have a frustrating time in. Yoshi obviously having a really strong armor jump, some pretty big normals that can be frustrating for ZSS to space around, but ZSS's insane mobility and pressure can just be so frustrating for any character like Yoshi, who has a lot of their movement stat really skewed. It can make it difficult for a character like Yoshi to get any sort of footing. So far it seems to be the case. Clovers got a really strong lead, and I seem to have gone to do my transition. Alright, and just as I do that, we fade into that first stock going to Clovers. We're going to be seeing, I want to say, a lot of more evasive play, at least for a little bit, until Clovers can get some kind of brain trap going against Sapphire here. Just at the moment, start poking at the Yoshi with aerials, trying to chase that tech with laser, although that doesn't seem to go anywhere. And unfortunately, getting clipped by the Yoshi tail. It's just going to go sink all the way down, down, down. Tricky there, managing to actually fully out of it, managing to pull out a lead. Sitting at a pretty uncomfortable percent for any character, but Yoshi's actually seems to be in favors. Not enough though, unfortunately. Clover's gonna make this right back to an even game, though. Sapphire getting the lead for even just a moment. I wonder if that's gonna be indicative for any character. Are you for the set? Egg roll going unpunished, proving the old adage quite true. Have you ever seen anyone punish egg roll in your life? Alright, that's the man. You're keeping the string going. Doing pretty solid damage. Obviously, not gonna close anything out of that, but still. Nothing like a good 40% is nothing to sneeze at by any stretch. Sapphire just looking for something big, a smash attack towards the side. Possibly trying to. Definitely looking for something with that jab there. I don't necessarily jab down these a true combo. I think it's more of a pressure mix. We've seen Sapphire trying to make a lot more capa do it, and the F smash is going to be the clincher for them. First game going to Sapphire. Next game. I think this is definitely a more conventional choice in terms of counter picks. We're looking at more of like a sword character. Having a lot of range to play with is certainly going to make Yoshi's life a bit more difficult. It means at the very, very least that egg roll is not going to be helpful, but almost dipping out really early with that air dodge there, with the American air dodge as it's become to be. This is about where Clovers starts building the lead, just being able to put on a back timer with side lead, and then sort of bobbing and weaving around Yoshi, trying to catch any whiff punish in order to start something, anything. And creating that sort of dynamic has worked so far, because we've kind of seen Clovers back off a bit and then with punish Sapphire for a 10-20 and then reset the situation all over again. It's not the flashiest method. It's not the flashiest method to be sure, but it's a very, very efficient strategy. Alright. Great up smash. This is the first stock going to Clovers. Pretty convincing here. Stage side B, and this is so honestly, if I'm a Sapphire, I'm thinking in terms of next game. This is a really hard deficit to make against a seasoned player like Clovers, especially in this particular matchup. He knows that this is ultimate. Anything can happen, especially if you're exposed to an airport. Yoshi definitely has the capacity to beat, but the only exploding Yoshi is doing is off the side right there as Clovers closes out game tier 2 with a very quick freestyle. See a new pick for this game number 3. Sephiroth. Interesting. I'm not sure that I necessarily love this one for Sephiroth, or love this one as a counter pick for Sephiroth. But this is we see the tier counter picks happen a lot. Even if they're not necessarily optimal, it's not like they're unfeasible as a choice. On Battlefield, this is not like undoable, like untenable of a situation for Sapphire by any stretch, but we shall just have to see. So far, though, this is going to be pretty solidly even. Sapphire looking for that kill out the side. Just anything to edge here. Back. And re-rising up there. Clovers is going to push first game, and with Wing active, I think Clovers still stands to push this lead even a little bit further. Great double up there, getting damage, losing one wing, but. Sapphire is in both a great position and percent to continue this juggle. I guess of course one, but it's not gonna sweet spot. Tech chase bash attack. The back air is closing out. This is really, really tough for Sapphire. I feel that the ledge should be killing Sephiroth around this point, especially with flashing skills, but how much is that really going to do for you? Goodness, the life of them. Sapphire just might seem to close out the stock for less. Unfortunately, Sapphire's choice for the F smash meant that he couldn't get anything off of the fire, but Clovers is going to do another American air dodge, this time directly down. Up throw up tilt. Valorant is in a tough position here. Clovers is in a. Clovers able to continue this trap here. Good coverage of the jump with fully charged uppy. That is going to go to 2-1 Clovers. Solid stuff.